Good morning. Today we are going to see the thermal conductivity of a good conductor by Forbes method. This is the required diagram of a thermal conducting material, that is a rod which is taken to be measured for thermal conductivity. It is a good conductor which has three different holes to insert the thermometers, which is heated by using a steam chamber. Now we'll see the construction of a good thermal conductor. For this, consider a long rod. One end of the rod is enclosed by a steam chamber for heating and the other rod is kept left free. The rod has a series of holes for inserting the thermometers, which are used to measure the thermal measurement. Now we'll see the working. The rod is heated till the steady state is reached. That is, amount of heat conducted per second across B is equal to the amount of heat lost per second between B and C. That is, the amount of heat conducted per second across B is equal to Ka theta d theta by dx, where K is thermal conductivity, A is area of cross section, d theta by dx is temperature gradient. Consider an element of thickness dx of the rod. That is, we are going to take a small piece of material from the complete rod. The mass of the element is equal to volume into density, that is A into dx into rho. Amount of heat lost per second is equal to mass into specific heat into rate of cooling. That is A dx rho s into d theta by dt. Here, the last per second between B and C is the integrated value of the above equation. That is, from B to C, A dx rho s d theta by dt. At this steady state, that is at equilibrium state, amount of heat lost per second is equal to amount of heat lost per second. That is, equation number 1 is equal to 3. Equate these two equations, that is Ka d theta by dx is equal to integration of B to C A dx rho x d theta by dt. Here we can cancel the common functions as A, and hence we are getting capital K is equal to rho s integration of B to C d theta by dt divided by d theta by dx. Now we are going to see the experimental part. It contains two parts. One is static experiment, other one is dynamic experiment. First one, static experiment for finding d theta by dx, that is change in temperature with respect to length of the material, that is d theta by dx. Next one is d theta by dt, that is change in temperature with respect to time. Okay. First, we'll see the static experiment. By static experiment, we are going to measure d theta by dx value. The rod is heated by the steam chamber till the steady state is reached. The temperatures are recorded by the thermometers at different points. The distance of the thermometers x from the hot end is noted. That is, from hot end to x1, hot end to x2, like that, the x values are noted. And a graph is drawn between the temperature and the distance. That is, the x value is taken, that is distance is taken in x axis and the temperature is taken in y axis. From x and y axis, we can obtain the slope value, that is d theta by dx, where d theta by dx is equal to the slope value, that is tan alpha. Now we are going to second method, that is dynamic method. In this method, a sample piece of rod is heated. A small piece is taken and heated. The heated piece is suspended in air and allowed to cool. The temperatures are noted at regular intervals of time. Here, a graph is drawn between d theta by dt and the distance x value at a constant x value. From this curve, the value, that is integrated value B to C is taken. That is B to C integration d theta by dt into dx is determined. From the area of shaded portion, we can measure the integrated value of d theta by dt. This is our equation number 6. By substituting the values of 5th and 6th equation in for equation number 4, we get k is equal to rho s into area of shaded portion divided by tan alpha. By knowing the values and substituting the values, we can get the K value, that is thermal conductivity of a good conductor, where K is equal to density, says specific heat, area of shaded portion and tan alpha. In this we have seen thermal conductivity measurement by a Forbes method for a good conductor. Thank you.